We have more breaking news in tonight. The president of the United States just issuing a slew of new pardons. I want to get straight over to Pamela Brown in Washington for us once again this evening. Pam, who's on the list?
Well, Kate, the president continues his revenge against the Russia investigation tonight by rewarding two former advisors indicted by special counsel Robert Mueller, issuing full pardons to his former campaign chairman, Paul Manafort, who was convicted for a slew of financial crimes, and to Roger Stone after commuting his sentence earlier this year. Also on this list, just released from the White House, Jared Kushner's father, Charles Kushner. Let's tick through these. Paul Manafort and Roger Stone. They were indicted by special counsel Robert Mueller, went to trial, convicted by juries of multiple crimes. Investigators say Manafort broke the cooperation agreement by lying to them. Roger Stone never cooperated after lying to Congress to protect the president and has never shown remorse. So now both men are being rewarded by the president for their loyalty. The president, as we know, Kate, has been long aggrieved by the Russia probe and has said he thinks his advisors were treated unfairly. It's worth noting here, the Mueller report detailed in the obstruction of justice part how Trump's team, Trump himself, dangled pardons as a way to protect himself. And now we're seeing the president's plan play out with these pardons here, these full pardons to Paul Manafort and Roger Stone. Also tonight, Charles Kushner, the father to the president's son-in-law, Jared Kushner. He was convicted of illegal campaign contributions, tax evasion, and witness tampering, and he served a 24-month sentence. Now, White House officials tell me that Jared did not advocate for his father to get the pardon because it was the unspoken word between him and Trump that this would happen. That is what sources have told me and my colleague, Gloria Borger. But overall, the story here, Kate, that is emerging from these pardons is that the president is using his pardon power to reward those close to him, some of whom likely would not have met the DOJ criteria for pardoning. And it's really significant when you think of this pardon for Paul Manafort. As you'll recall, Kate, me and my colleague Evan Perez, we were the first ones to break the news that Robert Mueller was indicting him. And so now to be sitting here saying that he has been given a full pardon by the president in the Russia probe is truly remarkable.